So where are we going?
Going to Philly, and then we're going to Miami, and then we're going to Quito.
Because I wanted to challenge myself and like broaden my horizons. I really thought I could be like that adventurous or like go to a place where I didn't know anybody or the culture or the language and feel so comfortable there, but it happened. I'm really excited that it did.
I applied for Albright because I had previous experience volunteering. I wanted to have a different experience during spring break instead of just going home and not doing anything important with my time. I was excited to go to Quito because I honestly have never traveled outside of the country before. I would experience so many different opportunities and meet new people and just have a great time, and I did. It was such an incredible experience.
So the center was started 53 years ago in 1964 by Padre Juan and Madre Miguel. It started with boys who were working as shoe shiners in the city of Quito. They took them in, Padre and Madre, and gave them an education as well. Then they realized that it would work best if they included the families of these boys. And so they started teaching the families about 10 core values. And the chief among those, I think, really are loyalty, family, and education. Padre and Madre have been fiercely dedicated to service their entire lives. And they really exemplify to me what it means to be passionate and to make a real impactful difference in the lives of others.
We're able to shadow some of the year-long volunteers at the center in classrooms working with the students. So the center itself runs kind of like a school. So there are kids all the way from preschool up through high school ages. And we were able to be in the classroom teaching English just with the students at the center. It was really unique for me to get to see where students come from in a different country and how they view their learning experience in the classroom differently from how students do in the U.S. And that was something that I really valued, and being able to especially not only be out of my element in a school in a different country, but working in another language and teaching them my first language was really unique.
So the first thing that we visited when we went down to the city center was the Basilica of Bomba Nacional. And what's really cool about it is that a lot of the architecture is inspired by the native animals to Ecuador and the Galapagos. And we actually had to kind of scale outside on this ladder to get to the top of one of the spires and it gave you this really beautiful view of the surroundings.
I think it's one of the most important things that we do when we're down in Ecuador. We go out on this huge mountain. It's a huge volunteering project with a ton of manual labor. You go up on the high in the mountains on this hot day. Sun's beating down on you the entire time, and you just do manual labor for like 4 to 5 hours. We helped this family hand dig out a hill next to their house so that they could put it on an addition to help poorer families in the community. During this, we dug out this hill. Moved all the dirt into two separate piles and leveled it. It took 20 of us 5 hours, so if the family had to do it themselves, it would have taken them weeks, maybe months. But the most important thing that I learned from Domingo was that the importance of like helping out with the community. The man who we were housed that we went to dig out this the hill next to, he was right alongside us the entire time. I mean, I would literally work next to him for 4 to 5 straight hours. And it just showed the importance of like, he had all these people like helping him, and he didn't like sit back and relax. He was joining like right in. He did just as much work, if not more, than everybody else that was there.
Some of the trades the center has is wood shop, automotive, sewing, as well as cosmetology. Trades are important because they provide them with a stable income as well as their family when they leave school.
One major goal of the center is to work with the kids, help them have a positive outlook on life, and just interact with them as much as possible. So going as a group, we really strive to hang out with them, interact with them, play soccer, volleyball, juggle the ball around. They really enjoy having us out there, very welcoming.
I think for me, I didn't really like kids going into it, so I was kind of anxious and nervous about spending so much time with them. But as I got to know them, I realized how precious they were and how much I enjoyed them. They were just happy all the time, and they were so welcoming and inviting and really fun to get to know. And they loved to try and get to know us and speak the little bit of English that they could, and it was super awesome trying to speak Spanish back to them and just asking them questions and knowing their names.
Also, being with the kids solidified my passion for working with children because I know I can have a bond with them, make connections, and ultimately make a positive impact in the world.
I think for me the most impacting thing about playing with the kids was this one day Joelle, he had cookies and he shared them with me and this other little girl on the playground even though he didn't need to. And I thought it was really sweet because they don't really have a lot where they come from. So not knowing like his circumstances at home or like what kind of food he's getting there, it really hit me because he was just so open to sharing with everyone and it was really sweet to see that.
So Quito and Dobrovolny, really all of Ecuador, they have this fast paced sense to them, but then again everything's also relaxed and you can go about your day, but there's always something going on. So two places that we went to that really highlight the culture would be the Dobrovolny market, where it brings in the products and colors of Indigenous and the Inca people that lived there before the Spanish conquistadors. And then we went to the soccer game, the Liga game, and there was just so many people. There was about 7 different entrances. It seemed like everybody was in a rush to get in, but at the same time, once you were in, you're like, yeah, whatever, this is a great time.
How do you view your life through differently since you turned in Ecuador?
So I feel like I'm more dedicated and more passionate in what I want to do. I think that's a result of being exposed to a different culture and meeting different people who are very dedicated and passionate to their work. I think I saw that and I wanted to exemplify that in my own life. So I've been working to be more dedicated in what I do.
Have at it, Christopher.
Yeah. What's the funniest thing that happened to you on this trip?
She kind of stumbled when she went to grab the ball, and she tumbled.
Do I have to tell you?
Yes.
Oh no, okay, I was, it went down so hard. I was playing volleyball with a bunch of kids, and I was just having the time of my life. I just started cry laughing in the dirt. It was just in like a puddle of dirt, and this kid helped me.
What three words would you use to describe Albury?
Oh, come on. I think it's challenging. I push my boundaries and people push their boundaries. Growing. I grew as a person. I think heartwarming. Because of the relationships you build, the people that you see, the relationships, you know, like everything, you know, it makes you feel happy and makes your heart feel warm.
How do you view your life here differently since returning from Ecuador?
A different perspective on life was huge for me. Coming back and seeing like, not everything, like the little things aren't necessarily as bad as you think they are. I guess when I see that, like I can put that in perspective of it's not like that bad.
How can you use what you learn on all grades to make the world a better place?
Okay, so one thing that I thought about when I got back was how they really were, they might not have had a lot, but they were thankful for what they did have. So just like instilling in people that might complain or not see the world as a better place. Like, I know you might not have a lot, but you can be thankful for what you do have.
My perspective on this question is that anyone can make a difference whether it's big or small.
Ooh, would you recommend Alt Break to other students?
Yeah, what you get out of Alt Break is, like, we put so much work and effort into Alt Break every time we go. Like, we did the manual labor thing, we did everything. Like, we put in so much and we still get out twice as much as we put in from all the people that we meet, the conversations we have with other people. 100% would recommend for the experience, definitely.
Quito!